So the people I want to thank the most are the families at home, because honestly, none of them would be here without you, and I know what it takes. I had kids of my own, and we had to get them to the rehearsal and had to maybe urge them to practice sometimes, and it's a lot to do with what you do at home, and also that you understand that they will be grateful you did. So now I'd like to introduce someone who also understands all of this, probably more than anyone, and that is our board president, Kim Hernandez.
Well, thank you. As I said, I love this organization. So if you know my story, and just very briefly, I've been part of this organization for 50 years. I started in what was Junior Strings, which is now Junior Orchestra. And you can read in your program a little bit about a special guest that will be speaking tonight, Rick Wolfgang, who actually transitioned the Junior Strings into the Junior Orchestra as a little bit more of a prep with a full orchestra for the youth symphony. So back when I was involved, there were just the two orchestras. And so it's come a long way. So if you read the program, you know when I graduated, because that's when Rick Wolfgang changed this into Junior Orchestra, but don't count the years. And I just want to say that as a student that was part of this, and then as a parent, my three children were involved with the Eugene-Springfield Youth Orchestras. And it's a wonderful organization. And I can't thank you enough for all of your support for your kids, as Holly said. And this is our 90th season coming up this next year. So there's a lot of exciting things planned. And I don't know if you knew, Holly, but two of the songs that people will be voting for at intermission, I played when I was in these orchestras. So the Egmont Overture and Finlandia were part of the repertoire that I played. I wasn't in the 1938 orchestra when that first hit, but I was. They played it a few times after that. I think I've covered most of the things that I wanted to talk about. I do have one cute story about us. They're going to play a piece tonight, and I won't give it away, but at the Junior Orchestra Outreach that you guys did at Springfield High School, I recorded part of it, and I played it for my two-year-old grandchild, and she kept saying, again, again, as she sang along. So you'll love it. If you're a fan of, well, you'll recognize it. So, again, thank you for being here tonight. One last thing. I have this flyer to remind me. We have a chamber camp this summer. There's flyers out in the lobby, so please pick them up. Please think about signing up and have something fun to do this summer. So, anything else?
Just about the three different pieces that you get to choose from. I'm not sure if you guys all know you each get a remote. So, at the end of the concert, when you go to the lobby for your celebration, you get a free remote of one of those, whichever one you like the best.
What they'll feature next year.
What they'll feature next year.
Yeah.
So I think that takes care of everything. Thanks so much for coming. We'll have a short intermission where I hope you will go to the lobby and see what's out there and make your vote.
And the online auction,
lots of good stuff, and it's tomorrow. So great. Well, without any more, we will introduce the Junior Orchestra and conductor Chris Noel.
Thank you. patient in being here, and it's hot. I feel hot. Is it hot up here? Cool. So I'm going to be brief, but I do have things I want to say. First of all, that is a three-movement divertimento by Mozart. And while the Junior Orchestra has played this before, I don't think they've ever played all of it. And there is no arranger. This is what Mozart wrote. And anybody out there who's a musician understands that Mozart is a hard composer to play. It's really difficult. The young people kind of think it's not that hard because Mozart also wrote Twinkle. And so we kind of think that it's easy, but it's not. Is it? Oh my gosh, you did so well. Thank you. Now, we are going to give you three different pieces, as you heard a little bit earlier. That's going to be like an incentivizing thing to go out during intermission and vote on what you want to hear the Youth Symphony. This is Junior Orchestra. The Youth Symphony play next year on our 90th anniversary. I also was not in this group 90 years ago, but I was in this group years ago. And I'm super interested to see what you like. We're going to give you teasers, kind of like a movie trailer of the three pieces. The first one's by Mozart. It's called Marriage of Figaro. The other translation of that opera is The Crazy Day, because it all happens in one day. And if you want more of that story, go look it up. It is a crazy day. The second one we're going to play is one of Beethoven's students of sorts. His name is Beethoven. And he wasn't so good at the operas, but this was an overture to an opera that did not really happen. Egmont overture. So that one is a little different flavor. And then the third one is by Sibelius, who's a Finnish composer. And his melody that we're going to play for you is so famous that it's like the soundtrack for the country. So those are our three choices, and we're going to give you a little snippet, just a trailer. And if I may just brag a little bit, they learned this on Monday. In like 10 minutes. They're like acting like professionals right now. Where here's the music, let's learn it now. And so let's see how it goes. Thank you.
Liked that one. That's Mozart, Marriage of Figaro. Keep that in mind. Beethoven, Egmont. for your voting. This starts really in minor. It's really dark. And then Beethoven at the end, in case you didn't know, he went deaf, and at a time, he was really depressed. And so this starts dark, and then at the end, it becomes glorious. So this is the second little trailer. One, two, three. There's more to the song. Now, Sibelius Finlandia, our final movement. This is the melody, but it starts with so much more. So all of these are just trailers. See what you like to listen to.
Came to rehearsal a few months ago, and the again tonight. It's just such a treasure. You, audience, musicians on stage, are such a treasure to Eugene. And I'm glad, I'm very happy that I had something to do with it. 50 years ago, I was a new band director at Roosevelt Junior High School then. And I started some oboe players and some horn players and some bassoon players, and they had no place to really play because band is not the best place for those instruments. They're orchestra instruments. And so I thought, let's put these together with the junior strings who happened to be rehearsing in my room. I think every Monday night I would hear them play and I think, wouldn't it be nice if we put the orchestra together? So here it is, almost 50 years later. Amazing. It's just really amazing. And it doesn't happen everywhere. There's hundreds and hundreds of cities across the United States that don't have an orchestra like this. And it happens because of an invisible group of people that you don't see, the board, the people who make everything happen behind the scenes. Just so many of those people, a whole page full of people that are precious, a treasure to Eugene. And it happens because there's a school program that promotes really good orchestra and good band. And it happens because you have a talented group of kids that love music, and you have challenged them and supported them to play in an orchestra like this, playing the real Mozart, the actual points on the page that you put down, and then to be sitting here and actually playing them. We'll stay with these kids forever. There may be other things they'll forget, and won't be playing their instruments for the rest of their life. But they'll be remembering some of the experiences they're having right here, right now, next week, or tomorrow night when they're doing the symphony. This Thursday, next Thursday, Carrie Bell is going to be playing with the Eugene Symphony. It's a clarinet player playing the Cobra clarinet concerto. And he was a junior orchestra member back in the days when I was conductor. So if you come and listen to the Eugene Symphony, you'll get an alumni, San Francisco Symphony Orchestra, first chair clarinet player who'll be playing. So I just wanted to show you how happy I am to be here, to listen to this group, to know that I had something to do with it. But really, you're the ones who make it happen now. And you care about this, and I care about this. So thank you so much.
Let's heat up the temperature a little bit.
With a piece that isn't that old. This group is much older. And if there's any young people in here, this is a guessing game. If there are older people in here, you can play too. See if you can figure out what this song is. We're going to deconstruct it before we play it. And then I'm going to guess most of you will know what it is.
To answer. Right? Who knows the answer? But what won't we do?
Talk about it.
We won't. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
we have the luxury in this organization to have a wind specialist, Mr. Christopher Holt, helping us figure out all the stuff, all the things. And now I want to feature the winds under the direction of Mr. Christopher Holt.
Thank you.
It's awards time. This has been such a cool year. Let's just put it in perspective. 2 years ago, I guess 3 years ago, 2 or 3 years ago, we were doing this online. And that was fun. And then last year, we were doing it in a larger space with masks, and each person could not have a stand partner. And it was a challenge. And now, it kind of reminds me of when I was in junior orchestra. And it's awards time. So we have a few awards to give out, and I don't think the students know it, unless people like secretly did that. Yes, I want you to come with me. Unless somebody leaked, these students might not know what's going on. So we have a plaque. This is the Laurie Eliason Award. One goes to Kayla Klein. Kayla Klein. Love this. They don't know what's happening. Okay, cool. Now, we have the same award again, but to another just wonderful musician, Kyla Hirsch.
All kinds of different things you can read about in your we get requests from the community to have musicians, and it's really a special thing for our community, for, you know, all these different events. But it's also, I hope, really really nice for the students to get out there. They get to play chamber music rather than, you know, the full orchestra. They do duets and trios and solos and quartets. And they're coached by someone who I left out of the program, although he is in the back. And his name is Ben Gardner. Can we just have a big round of applause?
Take about 50 more minutes on awards, because everybody in this group, you should see them on Mondays. It's an incredible group of kids. It's an incredible group of kids, and these are the kids that we should always be talking about. All the time. This on stage, right here. This is who we should celebrate. And these are the people who make it possible. So can you thank them? We have one more song. It's brief. Thank you for being here. At concerts and clap between movements as long as I'm around. Go for it. Yeah.